Technologuy, Sharyn and Clint podcast. I like it.
Hello, everybody, and welcome along to the Guy, Sharyn and Clint podcast.
Every day we do a podcast, and that's one of the great things about the podcast. It happens every day.
Why is it called a podcast?
Because it's not broadcast, it's cast on a smaller scale into people's iPods.
Yeah, iPod is where it comes
right.
from.
Right. Okay.
So it's, broadcasting
I'd prefer
iPods.
If we recorded our podcast inside a pod.
That's a good point.
Like, we kind of do.
Like Lady Gaga's pod egg that she went to the Grammys in.
Terrible acoustics.
I want us to sit in like a bath-shaped pod.
And a what shaped pod?
And we'll go from tallest to shortest.
What shaped pod?
Like, what?
What's shaped?
It's like a bath.
A bar.
Yeah, but it has like a roof. And then Guy will be at the back. And then Clint will be in the middle. And then I'll sit in the front.
Are we naked or clothed?
We're wearing blue jeans with denim shirts.
Yeah.
And cowboy hats.
It's amazing how vivid this is in your imagination.
And I just want to do the show like that. Because I think it will bring us closer.
We could sit like that and do the outro to this podcast if you want.
Today on the show, we have Chang's April...
I was just trying to wrap up the story. Okay. I just wanted to get, if we could,
Today on the show, we have Chang's horrible April Fool's story. We have technologuy. We have how does it feel chat about the chili. That guy was good value, actually. Really psyched Clint out. He's going to have to do that tomorrow. And we also have the new hit segment we did where we guessed how much money was in Megan's cleavage, which was a classic.
How come we didn't talk about the fact that you look like you just woke up and wearing a t-shirt and your baggy Barker's track pants with food stains?
There's no food stains on it. You always add little bits into the stories for regular listeners of the show.
Then what am I looking at?
She adds in a lot of
details
about my pants.
What am I looking at?
Like whenever she talks about my my pants being unbuttoned or something, it's not really true. She just adds that in for a bit of juice.
Actually, it's not. I have on multiple occasions seen half of your fly down and seen your panties.
Okay. And they're lovely. Thanks for listening to the podcast, and my pants are food free.
Guy, Sharyn and Clint on the edge.
I sometimes think that April Fool's Day was a prank invented by someone to prank us all into thinking we're good at pranks. Because every year it rolls around, and every year we do a terrible job of doing some good pranks, and we do not nail it at all. I think today's worst prank that I've heard of thus far would have to go to our very own Chang Hung. Chang, welcome to studio, mate.
Yep, hi.
Why am I the only one clapping for him?
I'm not clapping for him.
I'm not in the mood to clap for him.
Because as a fellow dog owner, this really upset me, because you don't tempt fate in this way.
Mm-hmm.
Chang put on his Facebook page today, and this is his April Fool's joke. R.I.P. Tough the Husky, you've been a good, loyal friend. This got liked by 100 people, and he got over 36 comments about this. And
Looking back at it now, it's kind of funny as to how stupid and moronic it is.
No, but people were like calling him, texting him, because this is Chang's best friend.
You've told us on a number of occasions that he's your best friend.
Yeah, it's the love of my life.
And you killed him for April Fool's Day.
What is it? If something happens to Tough now, it's your fault.
I know.
Because your dumb April Fool's joke.
Seriously, as soon as I posted it, my phone just couldn't stop going off. Text messages and calls.
It's the dog equivalent of you just going on your Facebook and going, "Ha, good morning, everybody. Mum's dead."
It's bad.
So Chang logged on to April Fool's. You thought, I'm going to think. What was your thinking behind it? You're like, I'm going to have a classic gag for April Fool's.
Well, I was lying in bed and I was like, what should I do? I'm gay once, and then people thought, oh, maybe that's not a joke. That's actually real.
Classic.
Yeah.
So, it would be obvious.
So you nailed that one, and you thought, based on my I'm gay prank, here's my new one.
Let me read you some of the feedback, and these are your friends. This is not a public page. This is a private page.
So Chang said his dog was dead, and this was the feedback.
OMG, he was beautiful. I'm sorry for your loss, Chang. XX. Another one. Very sorry to hear that, Chang. Sending lots of love. XX. Another one. That would be a pretty sick joke if he is joking that his dog died. And one more. Did you eat him?
No, I did not. Yeah, but I felt bad afterwards, yeah.
You should feel bad.
So you went on there, and this is your thing. In regards to the previous post, tough is all good in the hood. It was a bad April Fool's joke. Got so many messages and phone calls about the post. Tough and I feel very loved by you all. Apologies if it has offended you. Tough doesn't need to feel bad, yeah, because you were the one that did it. Don't drag him into it.
Oh, don't drag me into this,
Chad. And people have just gone on here and said, you shouldn't joke about something like that. You've ruined my day. And all that. I thought you were such a cool guy until I read your sick post.
So you've turned it.
Someone else I commented, still keen to eat him.
No!
So you've turned it into almost a heartfelt moment.
Yeah.
You've tried to spin it. You are a moron for
doing
this.
I know, I feel really bad.
You're just fishing for people to call and text.
That's
you?
That's what he was doing.
Come on.
So somewhere out there, I bet there's a million other terrible pranks.
Yes.
In New Zealand that have gone just as badly as this one. That's what we want to hear today. We want to hear your worst April Fool's Day pranks.
Yeah.
0800 The Edge or text into 3343.
Did someone try and do a worse one than Chang, or is that the worst?
I thought that the boss was going to reveal today that us working with Guy was an April Fool's joke.
It's not. It's permanent. Sucked in.
Only kidding.
It's a very long, very loud joke.
So we're getting some coming through the text machine through the phones, which are possibly even worse. I've got one here that says, one April Fool's Day, my friend texted me to say she was pregnant. I was quite shocked, as you would be. But not only that, you're happy as well. You're like excited about it. I was even more shocked because she had just finished a summer fling, .. with my brother.
Oh.
I all of a sudden got really worried about my friend, my brother, and my unborn niece, /nephew. Needless to say, I was really angry when I was, but relieved to find out that it was all just a hilarious prank. Every time, eh? Like, when do they ever go well? We almost need to find out ones that went well, because they don't seem to ever go well.
Karen, tell us about your April Fool's gone wrong.
So, 2 years ago, on April Fool's, the night before, I went out with my partner. I mean, not with my partner, with friends, and I came back, and the next day I rang my partner who was up in Auckland, and I told him that after the pub me and my friends went down to the river in my car and did some skids and I crashed it. And then anyway, that night I was travelling home to the west coast and I literally crashed my car and rode it off.
What?
Oh, so you tempted fate too close and fate came and crashed your car.
Yeah, yeah.
Jeepers, creepers.
That was, and when you rang your partner to tell him you actually had crashed your car, did he not believe you?
No, he didn't believe me. My friends didn't believe me.
Karen.
That's the thing. Now when Chang's dog does die, people are going to be like, oh, not this joke again. And Chang's going to be like, yeah, no, it's true. Tough is gone. But he's burnt that bridge.
You've done it as well, Karen. Every time you get a car crash now, no one's going to come and pick you up. Leighton, tell us about your April Fool's gag that went wrong.
Well, this morning I'm sitting on my laptop out in the lounge doing some work, and my girlfriend comes into the lounge, bawling her eyes out, and she says, "Read this." And it was a text message from her best friend saying that she was terminally ill and she only had 1 to 2 years to live.
No.
Yeah, we were just like, "Man, is that for real? That's not something you say over text." And no. And then we kind of realised about half an hour later that it was April Fool's.
Oh.
But not only that, she texted it to all her friends, and a couple of her friends actually rang her and said, "That is not something you joke about on an April Fool's Day. That's horrible.
No, that is something you should never, ever, ever, ever joke about."
Some people just don't know where the line is. They don't know.
So awkward as well. Oh, my goodness.
Yeah. Where's the payoff? You're not going to laugh and be like, "Oh, you got me so good. I was so worried about you."
So we are confirming that that was definitely not true.
Yeah, definitely. It wasn't true, yeah.
Oh, that actually makes me feel sick that somebody would do a joke like that. That is such a horrible
April
joke.
April Fools! I'm still alive, guys. You should appreciate me for being alive. You know what? We now wish you were dead.
No, whoa, okay. That was bad, too. Leighton, she definitely owes you guys a whole lot of drinks or something.
Or something, for sure.
Oh, man. Oh, that actually makes me feel sick someone would do that.
Good. All right. Happy April Fool's Day, everybody.
Guy, Sharyn, and Clint
on The Edge.
It's time now for Technologuy, where Sharyn's excited.
I'm excited because I just think this is going to be as good as Uber Facts.
Hey, I appreciate the support also maybe because you're in this one as well. Today, technologuy outlines the most exciting people who are on... I should have said annoying. The most annoying people on Facebook. We've all got those people. The people who post like inspirational quotes about loving yourself, and then they're like the most like shallow people. Or do you know those people who post science posts sometimes?
Yes, all the people that post baby pictures every single day.
Unbelievable. Or car pictures, like it's a baby.
Or, or political statements.
Oh, yeah. Oh, my God. A political argument on Facebook is the dumbest and most irritating thing in the world. Well, I love the science posts where they're like, it's like a science post, but it's really just a picture of some stars. And like, science. Space is everywhere. Anyway.
Also known as the most hidden people on Facebook.
Yeah.
The people most likely to be hidden by all of their friends. Why is no one commenting on my stuff anymore?
So I decided, Technologuy decided to create a segment where he ran through some of the most annoying stereotypes on Facebook. Let's check it out.
Hello, and welcome to Technologuy. Today we're going to talk about Facebook and the people who use it, aka the worst people in the world. Facebook users can be broken down into a variety of categories. Let's talk about the ones who should be arrested for crimes against humanity. First up, the cool story broer.
Still recovering from the big one last night. P.S. Sorry, liver.
No one cares.
Stole a traffic cone.
Still no one cares.
The Mysterio.
OMG, I am so sad.
What's wrong?
I don't want to talk about it.
Then don't put it on your status. The TMI-er.
I'm currently having some dumplings.
No one cares.
Having a bath.
So what, do you want me to join you? The passive-aggressive poster.
Ain't it funny how some people come over to your house 2 hours late and then eat all your snacks and then make rude comments about your brother and then leave without even saying goodbye?
Clint, if you have a problem with me, say it to my face. Don't post it on Facebook for everyone to see.
Huh, wasn't even about you. Ain't it funny how some people think everything's about them?
The humanitarians.
Do you happen to know that I helped end child hunger by changing my profile picture?
This is BS.
I know which of my friends will care enough to take the time to share this.
I'm going to stab you now.
I'm a good person. I'm affecting change. I'm making the world a better place around me.
I'm going to stab myself now.
Ooh, now back to the Candy Crush saga.
Oh, merciful Lord, please just take me now.
That's all for Technologuy this week. We'll see you next week.
Guy, Sharyn and Clint.
On the edge.
Last week on the show, we introduced a new segment called How Does It Feel? We have the aim of feeling everything in the world for the reasons of science and reporting back to you, the people of New Zealand. Last week, I experienced IPL surgery, which is laser hair removal, plus waxing.
I am just throwing in the hat again this week. How does it feel to be spooned by Richie McCaw? Just okay. Let me know if that's
we'll put that doing? On the list, but we're not doing it straight away. I feel
Damn
like you're
it.
Gonna rig that one. This week for How Does It Feel, we are gonna be testing the hottest chili in the entire world.
And one of us will eat it.
Someone has to do it. I've got a winning spinning wheel here with all four of our names on here, including Chang's, and someone is going to have to eat the world's hottest chili. Plus, we're going to talk to the person who made the chili next.
Yeah, a chili expert who can tell us what we're in for.
In its entirety or just a bite?
We'll figure that out.
Oh, God.
It's going to kill you.
Do we have to swallow?
Always, babes.
Ooh. So not really coming back from that.
So awesome we have When You're Alone and You're Cold Inside on the How Does It Feel sting. This is How Does It Feel, the hit new segment. This week we're going to find out how it feels to eat the world's hottest chili. This is why.
Sorry,
I
was just Googling what the world's hottest chili was, and it just actually scared the living bejesus out of me.
The shock and scare, the fear in you guys' eyes, I can see right now. We're going to spin a wheel soon to find out who's going to eat it, but first we need to talk to the guy who made the world's hottest chili.
Well, we've actually got someone on the phone right now who's going to supply us with New Zealand's hottest chili. We've got Clint from Fire Dragon's Chilies, which is so exciting.
Clint, did you say Clint?
His name's Clint as well. Hi, Clint.
Hi, how you going?
Great name, brother. Welcome to the show.
Yes, bro.
Never have too much Clint on this show.
Now, we need to talk about this chili. I'm not that excited about it because it sounds too hot. On the scale of 1 to 10, how hot is this chili?
Oh, probably a 15.
Oh, wow. God! Is it going to be one that, like, it's so hot it could make you spew or something?
Basically, I'd say whoever eats it will probably throw up. They might start ripping their clothes off and rolling around on the ground in fetal position as well. I don't normally just give these things out to anyone to eat, you know?
What? Are they a controlled substance?
No, they're not a controlled substance, but you certainly need to be careful when eating them.
Is it like the chili that was in that Simpsons episode when Homer Simpson ended up having this massive hallucination trip and he was like going through the desert and all that sort of stuff?
Yeah, something like that. I don't know if you hallucinate as much as what he does in that, but yeah, you could be hallucinating. Definitely a chance of that.
Oh my God.
Clint, I don't mean to be rude, but I'm going to be rude and say, what the hell is wrong with you? Why do you grow such a horrible thing? What is the purpose of this?
Well, I make the hottest sauces in New Zealand pretty much, so we started growing the Butcholokia, which was the ghost chili, back in about 07.
Yeah.
And that was the hottest then at kind of a million Scovilles. And the Carolina Reaper now, from testing in the States, it's got to be developed in South Carolina. Yeah. It sort of averages 1.5 million and can peak at 2.2 million Scovilles.
So Scovilles, just to understand Scovilles, what would be like a spicy, a spicy Tabasco sauce or something? Like, how many Scovilles would that be?
I think around 7,500, 10,000.
7,500? And how much is the,
God.
And how much is the chili?
Well, it can be over 2 million. So
2 million!
Holy crap.
Pepper spray rates about 2 million to 5 million. Scovilles.
So we're eating pepper spray?
Pretty much. Pretty much.
Christ on a bike.
This is amazing.
This is natural, so it'll taste much better than getting sprayed in your mouth.
We haven't chosen who's eating this chili yet, but you, being the person who knows what it's like, who would you like to see eat this chili? Would you like to see Guy, Sharyn, me, the original Clint, or Chang eat the chili?
Look, like I said to Chang, I was like, this is his responsibility if you guys want to eat it, because you definitely don't want to do it on an empty stomach. And, yeah, you certainly want ice cream, milk, yogurt, stuff like that around, because, yeah, you're going to be in a lot of pain.
This is easily the dumbest thing we've ever done.
So is it just me and Chang?
No, everyone.
It's up to Clint. Clint has to choose.
Well, I don't really care. I'll be on the wheel.
Put it this way. Does anyone have any heart, bowel or intestinal problems?
No.
No.
I'm prepared to make some up if it gets me out of the challenge, but I feel like I have to do it.
You're all fairly young, so yeah, you can handle it. You probably should all be in. It's your show.
Hey, thank you very much.
No, I've got real bad anxiety. Does that help? Like, if I've got breathing difficulties? Because this could be the one time it comes in good handy for me.
Breathing difficulties, yeah. If you got asthma, breathing difficulties,
yes!
That could rule you out.
I don't have asthma. I just get bad anxiety.
I wear glasses. Does that count me out? We're all in, guys.
Fog up. You might need to take them off.
No one's pussying out. We're doing this, Clint. Thank you so much.
Clint, we'll be in touch, mate, because we're going to need to know how to medicate ourselves pre, post, and during this chili eating competition. Thank you. When you're alone
and you're cold inside. How does it feel? The segment where we find out how things feel. We want to figure out how everything in the world feels. This week, we're going to find out how it feels to eat the world's hottest chili. I've just had a text in from the text machine saying, guys, this is serious stuff. I've seen on the news about people who end up in hospital.
I'm actually really, really not keen on doing this, because I read on Facebook one of my friends had tried this on the weekend. They said it was sweet to eat, but the next day they were too sick to go anywhere because they had to be in close vicinity of the toilet.
If you're not put off by the spice, then the diarrhea is going to get you. Chang, Chang, you're putting on a tough face.
Yeah, I don't eat spicy stuff, so.
Don't you? I would have thought you would.
I don't. What, because I'm Asian?
Racial. Yeah. Clint, what's your opinion? Because you're putting on a tough face being a tough man.
I've eaten a chili before.
We've all eaten chilies, mate.
Yeah, but this is way hotter than that.
For the listeners at home who missed us talking to the guy who grows the chilies, he said that Tabasco sauce, which for me is really spicy, that's 7,000 Scovilles. This chili is 2 million Scovilles. It's on a level with police-issued pepper spray.
Well, I haven't been pepper sprayed. So.
Honestly, I got given my very first Bloody Mary not long ago, and they're like made with Tabasco sauce. That made me cough so much because it was so spicy. I'm gonna die in here.
Okay, let's figure out once and for all who is going to experience this. Hopefully tomorrow when the chilies arrive. To do that, we've brought in the most sadistic man we know, the boss, Leon.
That is terrible. It's awful.
Good afternoon.
Sadistic for listeners. I put you three together.
That is true.
We're all on the wheel. We've all got an equal quarter chance of winning.
Don't spin me up, Leon.
Let's just get this over and done with.
Hard spin.
Anyone but me.
It's like Russian roulette.
Please not me. Please not me.
I did it last week.
No.
Clint has got it.
Clint. Yes. This is the best day ever.
He would say he's the hottest man on the show, so it's appropriate.
I love you so much right now, Leon.
Not according to the bloody TV guy.
I feel bad about this because Clint has tried to put on a tough face and now he is going to be brought to his knees by the world's hottest chili.
No, I'm actually stoked about this because he's being all cocky now. He won't be cocky tomorrow, will he?
It's gonna be so embarrassing for him, Clint. How do you feel, Matt?
I'm up for it.
You reckon you can take
it? Is that all you've got?
Well, I'm really keen on the ice cream and the milk and the... Was it cheese or yogurt that you've got to have afterwards?
No, we're not having any of those.
Way to put a positive spin on it.
We have to. The chili man said that you have to eat those things. That's the medicating bit.
Our budget ran out for that.
Are you,
secretly, I'm terrified.
What are your thoughts on guaranteed diarrhea?
and not just normal, like burning
by
hot.
By the way, can I just add to
this?
You're
basically going to poo lava.
Yes. Yesterday on Sharyn's Uber Facts, we learnt the fact that a great way to cure any sort of bowel problems is by chugging
some tomato sauce.
So we'll bring some tomato sauce along as well, just to help with the whole flow.
And just also, if you're going to reference Uber Facts again, call it its right name. Uber Facts!
All right, well, that was the right name. Okay. And that was How Does It Feel? Tomorrow on the show, Clint is going to be going into the fiery gates of hell.
I'll be eating the what? The Reaper.
You're going to be eating the most spicy chili in the history of all time.
Bring it on.
Going to be amazing.
Guy, Sharyn and Clint.
On the Edge.
Have you ever Googled yourself? Because one of our workmates Googled Guy the other day, and the things that came up were amazing.
When I started in stand-up, someone told me, a visiting comedian, asked to go, what's one tip? And he said, never Google yourself. And this is why, because the stuff that comes up is really, really weird.
Well, the things that have come up about Guy in particular, I think we should just go through like a Q&A right now.
Okay, and find out if they're true or not.
It's pretty amazing, the weird things that came up. So a big shout out to Kate that found this for us as well. So we'll start right now. Okay, Guy Williams. How old is Guy Williams?
26 years old. Yeah, 26 years old.
Okay, how tall is Guy Williams?
Tall enough to be afraid of ceiling fans.
Who is Guy Williams?
1.98 metres, 6'5", very tall.
Are you 2 centimetres off 2 metres?
Yeah, I wear shoes. These shoes have got like about a 2 centimetre sole, don't they? I'm just about there.
Yeah.
It's pretty weird, eh? I have to duck under doors. It's very embarrassing.
Who is Guy Williams' girlfriend?
Oh, that's the million-dollar question, isn't it?
I can't answer that. I don't want to say. Not on the radio. No comment.
It was in the paper, mate.
No comment.
Just answer it.
Continue with the segment.
We ask that question every week. We're still not sure of the answer.
He is the sneakiest person ever.
I'm not sneaky. I just don't want to be in the paper. That's all.
No, you just... Well, you can tell us. We're your friends.
You guys are great friends. He'll talk about it on the radio. Continue.
Who is Guy Williams?
I'm one third of the drive show on the Edge
Boring.
Called Guy, Sharyn and Clint.
Next question. I was talking
about you.
Who is Guy Williams dating?
Another one, and I can't answer that one. I'm sorry.
Boring. Where is Guy Williams' yard? I don't know why that matters.
I live in an apartment at the moment, so I don't have a yard. But if I had to say one, the park.
And this is when it gets weird. Where is Guy Williams buried?
Ooh.
No one knows because I haven't revealed that yet.
I'm still alive, people. I'm still alive.
Next question. Is Guy Williams dead?
Oh, my God. If you Google that, you've got way too much spare time on your hands because I am very much alive and sexy as always.
They obviously just know Paul Henry's plan.
I can't believe
Last one. Is Guy Williams still alive? No, sorry. How is Guy Williams still alive?
Can I just say to all those rumours, I'm alive and kicking and sexier than ever, and I just love how many people are outraged that I am the sexiest man in New Zealand. Suck it, people. I'm still alive and I'm banging as always.
Can you just shut up about winning that damn award? We know that you won it. We don't want to hear about it all the time because clearly everything's about Uber Facts these days.
Just Google that next time, guys. I'm a sexy man.
Guy, Sharyn and Clint
on the Bloody Edge.
Pretty's not the only thing that hurts around here. Is it Guy?
Well, don't say that if you're not going to explain what it is.
We can't say what that is.
We were having a grown-up conversation off-air about
public healthcare.
Public healthcare. which sounds so weird that we'd have a conversation about that. And Guy said, if I was a smoker, I'm not, but if I was and I went to, if I got lung cancer and went to hospital, he would rather I died than the government paid for
no,
me.
No, you made it sound way, way
that
worse.
That is what you said.
I'm saying that you if it's self-inflicted, then you should pay for it. That's what I'm saying.
So if I couldn't afford it and I was going to die, you'd be sweet with me dying.
I'm saying if I went out tomorrow and bought a motorbike and smashed my face into a wall, I should have to pay for my own treatment because I did it to myself. That's what I'm saying.
This is
Sharyn, I love you, and I wish you nothing but the best, babes. Now, good luck with Scandal.
Thanks, babes.
You don't have to worry about it because you're not a smoker.
Exactly.
Guy, Sharyn and Clint. Itch.
We've all had this moment when you've been talking about somebody and they walk into the room.
So incredibly stressful and weird morning this morning. And I say stressful because I need to kind of set up the mindset I was in. I was at work, I was getting grilled from all sides, and just when I thought I was in deep trouble and I had this meeting, someone came up to me at my desk and said, "Hey Guy, Will Seal's here to see you." Mm-hmm. And I had completely forgotten about this meal.
Who's Will Seal?
Will Seal is a guy I work with who comes with me with heaps of good marketing ideas. He's a great guy. I love him. He's a close personal friend, and I'm going to have him as the best man at my wedding. Okay? So as soon as someone goes, "Hey Guy, Will Seal's here to see you," I'd completely forgotten about that. I didn't need it. So I go, "Oh, not effing Will Seal." Just as that happens, Will Seal walks in the door and goes, "Hey Guy, good to see you, mate."
Well, the best part about this is that's not the first time you've been talking about Will Seal before he walked into a room, because we've got Will on the phone right now. Will, welcome to the show.
Hi, gang.
Hello, Will Seal.
Now, tell us, how do you feel about this situation that Guy's just said this about you?
I am so sorry, mate.
Well, you know, I mean, I don't feel too bad about it personally, but on a business level, you know, decisions get made, you know. Budgets get looked at, you know, just those kind of things come into play.
And bridges get burnt, right, Will Seal, and it's hard to cross a bridge once it's been burned.
It's very true, and Guy is aware of, you know, mistakes have been made, things like that, you know. Black marks get added up, those sort of little things.
Did you know that he had said this about you, Will?
No, not until now.
Not until right now.
So if I just hadn't told this story, you wouldn't even have noticed.
I was blissfully unaware.
Oh, my God.
You're like Judas. You're like Judas right now.
Well, I am so sorry, mate. I always appreciate your meetings. It was just bad time this morning, mate. And I love everything you do. You do a beautiful job, and you dress great, and you're a handsome man as well.
We'll have a meeting tomorrow and talk about it. Don't worry about it.
Thank you, if and Will Seal, as Guy refers to you.
All right. My pleasure.
We want to know from you this afternoon when you have awkwardly talked about someone while they've been in the room. You didn't know they were there, you started bad-mouthing them, you were spilling secrets about them, coincidentally, they were probably standing right behind you listening to the whole thing. You can give us a call right now on 0800 The Edge, you can text us at 3343, or you can join the convo on Twitter too using the hashtag GSC Show.
Kelsey, when have you been caught talking about somebody and they've just bolted into the room?
It was the other night, our friend. We had to go grab some stuff, and we'd kind of been trying to set the two of them up. And so we're standing there talking about how they'd probably gone out to hook up and stuff. And then they came and snuck in the fire escape at the back to give us a fright. And they walked in just as we had said that one of them liked the other. And the girl started crying.
Oh, what? God, that would have been so... Was she crying because you guys had embarrassed her?
Yeah, kind of. She's bit of a soft touch, but we did some backing for it to make up for it.
That poor, poor girl.
So are they getting together, though? Has it worked?
Did it work?
Yeah, I think we might have something coming in the future. So in saying that, we probably didn't even need to do any baking. We set her up for life.
Yeah, that is true. You found her husband. Good work, Kelsey. Andrea, when have you talked about someone and got caught?
So I just started a new job and I was trying to impress all my workmates, and we worked with this guy who had really, really tight pants, and so I was like mocking him and, you know, "Oh, look at me with the tight pants," you know.
Oh, no.
Great burn.
It was really embarrassing, and the girl sort of stopped laughing, and I'm like, I kept going, look at me. And one of the girls just said to me, "He's right behind you." You know?
Isn't that just the worst feeling ever as well?
Yeah, yeah, my face just dropped. I kind of skulked off to my desk and didn't look up for the rest of the day. I was mortified.
I'm not surprised.
Crit right up behind you, but you couldn't hear him because there was no swishing of his baggy jeans. I just too tight and just pranced up behind you. Like, I tell you, I'm right here.
To this day, I'm mostly just angry at my friends for saying he's right behind you.
She said,
oh, hi, or something like that.
But she could have glossed over it like you weren't talking about him, Andrea. That is really, really awkward. And it seems like this is the sort of thing that girls always get caught doing because, Sarah, you've been caught as well.
I have, yes. Well, I mean, fortunately, I just got to hear about and have a laugh because I was the person they were gossiping about. But yes.
What were they saying about you?
Well, my girlfriend was at a work party and one of the sisters of another girl that was there was saying that she'd heard some gossip going around our work that a manager, which was me, had broken up with her boyfriend to experiment with a girl that also was at the business.
Wow!
Oh my God. What did you do?
That girl was in the room and everyone knew but the sister.
That is so... I would have lost my absolute rag. Did you tell her off?
Well, when I heard about it, I was a little bit like, thanks for gossiping about me. You know, you don't know what you're talking about. This isn't some, you know, lesbian gossip that gets to get stirred around. But then I actually just had to laugh because really the embarrassment was on her.
I'm also very confused at the same time. So was any of it true?
Not the experiment part. She's more than an experiment. We've been together a couple of years.
Oh, so you did break up with your boyfriend and you did get together with a woman?
Yes, I did.
Oh!
Well, then you can kind of understand how that's very juicy gossip in the workplace, though, can't you?
I know, but, you know, it's got to be recent gossip. It's not gossip of a couple of years old. Otherwise, it's just your time, darling.
Yeah, understandable.
Very good point. Thank you so much for that. It was awesome.
No worries.
So, lesson learned, Guy. You're all good?
Well, I think we've all learned a valuable lesson, which is...
Talk quieter.
That's one of them. But more importantly, don't say anything about someone that you wouldn't say to their...
Guy, Sharyn, and Clint.
On the Edge.
One of those moments when someone tells you something off-air that you think, this has got to go out to the people of New Zealand. Sharyn was just telling us about the weird sound her husband was making in bed. Is this embarrassing for you to talk about, Sharyn?
I just texted him and said I was going to talk about it. He said, that's very insulting. but I'm going to tell it anyway. He'll be right. So last night, my husband Bryce sleeps on his back. And a couple of times he's vomited and choked in his sleep.
Jesus.
And I don't know if it's a reflux thing or whatever, but he's like... And I've woken up before and I just have this reflex now where if he makes a weird noise when we're sleeping, I just spring into action. I'm like, ah! And I turn the light, I flick the light, which is by my side, and then I push him into the recovery position.
Okay.
And so anytime he does something weird, I'm like a cat. I'm all over it. I'm just like, bang, bang.
It's a very stressful way to sleep.
Well, because I don't want him to die. I wouldn't be able to live without him. He pays all of our bills for us. I don't know how to do any of that stuff.
That was almost a beautiful moment until you said the bills.
No, I was just joking. I couldn't, honestly. If my husband died...
I'm trying to make up for it now, mate.
I would never leave the... I would never be on the radio again. I'd never leave the house. But...
What a loss to New Zealand.
Because I couldn't afford gas because he fills up the cars.
No, he does. Honestly, I wouldn't function. But last night, we were asleep, and I was struggling to sleep last night. I honestly got about 3 hours sleep in total, and I just drifted off to sleep. And all of a sudden, I hear this, oh, like a howl. And I, straight away, because the dog sleeps in our room, I got up, and I was like, no, it wasn't the dog. And I just elbowed Bryce over straight away, putting him in the recovery position. And he's like, oh, what? And I was like, you just howled. And he was like, classic. And then just rolled over back to sleep on his back. And so I woke him up again. I was like, what were you howling at? And he goes, you wouldn't get it, mate. And just carried on sleeping. I was like, I wouldn't get it. You just gave me the nightmare of my life, thinking that he was dying or something. And he's just like, oh, howling in his sleep.
People do weird things in their sleep.
Well, I've had choking and I've had screaming of him in the sleep before, and now he's howling. What's bloody next? Am I married to a werewolf?
That is pretty weird, and that is a little bit werewolfy. But what I think is more weird is the fact that you stay up at night watching him sleep.
No, I wasn't watching. I just couldn't. I was. Just
You're the weirdo. We've got to figure that out. That's the real problem.
No, I just can't sleep because I continuously think about work and things I have to do.
What do you think about work?
Well, because I don't know, just to think of things. So the you know we're good.
Think of good things to say. You're like so while you're thinking of things to say, this thing happened.
Oh.
There was something to say.
Oh yeah, well I'll just think of weird things.
It's
like,
the circle of life.
Do you know what? I actually woke up at 2 o'clock last night because I helped schedule the music, and I was like, oh Sharyn, you put two ballads together. And I remembered exactly where it was,
and it woke me up.
And then I just got back to sleep from worrying about that, and I got woken up by Bryce the Wolf.
You were worried you put two ballads together. This is something that needs counselling, and it's too big for the radio, mate.
Guy, Sharyn, and Clint. Itch.
Megan's hiding something right now.
Mm. Hello, Megan.
Hello.
She always, always puts things in here. Mm. On Friday at JJ's 40th birthday party, she put cake in there.
Mm. A lot of cake, too.
It's not a place that you put cake.
We were sitting at the table and she says, look what I'm hiding. And she pulls out a piece of cake, puts it on the table. It was wrapped in a napkin, so it was sanitary. And then I was like, wow, you hid cake in there? And she goes, yep, that's not all. Grabs another bit. I say, there's a lot of cake. And she goes, you think that's a lot of cake? How about this? And put another piece on the table.
Is this true?
And then people started eating the cake.
This is insane.
Yeah. I've asked to borrow something off Megan before.
Mm.
And I was like, hey, babe, can I borrow your lighter for the birthday cake?
She didn't keep that in there, did she?
Because we had a birthday cake. And then she pulled it out of there. And I was like, I don't want to touch it now. It's been in there.
The weird bit was, just before, Chan came in with his phone and he was like, Megan, we need to take a picture of this place so that we can put it on the internet. And I said, Chang, first of all, you can't ask that of her, and second of all, it'll get banned from Facebook if we put a picture of this on our Facebook page.
It definitely would.
It's quite big.
You guys are talking in riddles.
No, honestly, I can't believe how much stuff she can fit in there. It's like Mary Poppins' bag.
It is, actually.
It's like the Barney bag.
I don't even know what's in there half the time.
Megan, from the Edgework Day of Awesome, also our beautiful newsreader this afternoon, keeps everything, and I mean everything, instead of using a handbag, in her fun bags.
Yes.
Her breasts.
And her boobies.
She just stuffs things in there. Even if she's wearing a tight top.
Science.
You sound surprised, Guy. Where did you think we were talking about?
Let's not talk about me. I was bamboozled.
If I'm honest, Megan, I love you. Yes. I freaking hate how girls do this. Just get a handbag.
I hate handbags.
It just annoys me because it just looks so unclassy when girls just pull things out of their boobs.
I know.
Maybe I'm getting old, but
I've seen you pull things out of there before too.
Yes.
You fish around for quite a while because you're like, did I put it on this side of them? No. Did I put it on this side
of them?
There's
a lot of surface
is
area.
Is it in the middle left? No. Is it in the middle right? Is it right? Oh, it's there.
Can
it is.
Can we
at
say that most of these stories are when I've had quite a few to drink?
How does that improve anything?
Yeah, are you drinking on air? Because you did this morning.
Okay, that's true. I hate handbags.
Don't be proud of it, mate. I think it's absolutely fine.
Why did you have cake in there?
I wondered if I was going to get hungry on the dance floor, and I needed to have easy access to the cake.
Amazing.
That's incredible. This is JJ Feeney's birthday cake that was down there, by the way.
Amazing.
Which, if it's JJ's birthday cake, she'd be glad to know it was near some boobs.
Now, I thought we could play a game with this. Do you keep money in there?
Yes.
So you don't have a wallet?
No, well, I have a wallet, but it's much easier just to, like, the thing is, I don't like taking my wallet out to town either because I will lose things. I'm like a Sophie Hallride, the producer Sophie. I lose everything. So if I keep it in my boobs, I can't physically drop it.
You can't lose your boobs.
I can't lose my boobs.
That's what everyone says.
What if you met someone and then in the throes of passion.
Oh, yeah, that's great.
The next morning, you're fishing around for your stuff on their floor.
No, yeah, it's happened. Well, the thing is, Sharyn, it's kind of good because sometimes, like coins, for example, or IDs will just stick to the skin.
How good is the moment where she's about to reveal and she's about to take off the bra and she just opens it up and not only do you get the boobs, but you also get presents.
Cake and prizes.
Surprise!
Cake and cash.
You're like an Easter egg. You crack the egg and you get the goodies inside.
No, this is the best day ever.
This is how the game works. And we'll reimburse you, Megan, so you can be honest.
Okay.
If you can guess how much money is in Megan's boobs at the moment, you can have that money.
It's a new hit game.
What's the song going
to
be?
Let's pitch this to TV3. We need a song.
We need a song.
Ballpark it a bit as well. Give us. Is it less than $100?
Yes, definitely. I'm not. It's. I need pay.
Okay.
So.
Let's take some calls right
booby,
now.
Booby 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 booby
booby booby booby booby booby booby booby booby booby booby booby booby booby booby booby booby booby booby booby booby booby booby booby booby booby booby booby booby booby booby booby booby booby booby booby booby booby booby booby booby booby booby booby booby booby booby booby booby booby booby booby booby booby booby booby booby booby booby booby booby booby booby booby booby booby booby booby booby booby booby booby booby booby booby booby booby booby booby booby booby booby booby booby booby booby booby booby booby booby booby booby booby booby booby booby booby booby booby booby booby booby booby booby booby booby booby booby booby booby booby booby booby booby booby booby booby booby booby booby booby booby booby booby booby booby booby booby booby booby booby booby booby booby booby booby booby booby booby booby booby booby booby booby booby booby booby booby booby booby booby booby booby booby booby booby booby booby booby booby booby booby booby booby booby booby booby booby booby booby booby booby booby booby booby booby booby booby booby booby booby booby booby booby booby booby booby booby booby booby booby booby booby booby booby booby booby worst hiding place ever. Like,
could be worse.
Come on, girl.
It is time to play our brand new game show.
Booby 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 booby
booby booby booby booby booby
booby booby. We did that way better the first time, guys. I'm disappointed in our own behavior. So we found out today that Megan from the Edge Workday of Awesome hides pretty much everything in her boobs, from money to lighters to cash to cake. And I said cash and money twice, don't worry about it. We've got cash in there right now that Megan already had. We will reimburse her for this. You just have to guess how much is in the ditties. So call us on 0800 The Edge or text us to 3343. If you guess correctly, then you will win the booby prize.
Megan, empty the money out now. Go.
Empty it out.
Yeah, empty it out onto the table. I won't look.
Are there coins in there?
Yeah, there are coins. Okay, well, this is actually...
Oh, I'm definitely looking.
Can you hear that?
Yeah.
Yeah, I just saw a nipple.
I think I saw a nipple too. Wait, okay, this it's right
it
down.
Sounds like you're in a cave.
Why have you got a biscuit in there?
Is there
worst
more?
Sound of yes, there's more. Wait a second.
Clint, stop looking.
There we go, it's out.
Okay, don't tell us how much is in there.
It's on the table. The money is there. The prize is there.
There's Sean, notes and coins.
How much are in Megan's boobs?
I reckon about $45.
Oh, no.
Higher or lower, Megan?
Lower.
Lower. Okay.
It sounded like a low. You could tell from her voice.
Darren, what's your guess?
$28.
So close.
So close.
Really close.
Oh. Close, but no boob cigar?
No boob cigar. Work.
She's not Monica Lewinsky. Abby, what's your guess?
25.
No. Not 25?
Up.
Oh,
up from there?
Up.
Okay.
You are up. Down from 28, up from 25.
We're so close. Is it a cent or is it a dollar amount?
There is a cent amount as well.
Oh my goodness, I'm going to be guessing all day.
Becky, what's your guess for the money in Megan's breasts?
I think there's $32.50.
No, lower.
No,
it's lower than $32.50. It is close to payday. So Sheldon, what's your guess?
29.
Lower.
Okay. Lower. Okay. Okay. We're closing in.
People are pretty. We've just had two people guess above 28. We've already heard it's below 28.
Below 28, above 25.
Those are our parameters.
Okay. Josh. Oh, no. Josh is gone. Okay. We'll take this person live. Edge, hello. What is your guess? Oh, turn your radio off, mate, because you're freaking me out.
Right, choke them on hold. You know what we can do? We can play a song.
Yes, let's
come
do that.
Back with some more guesses. Let's load
that.
Some more up. And we'll find out how much. And you can, while we're playing the song, you can dig around and check if there's any more in there, Megan.
Okay. How much is in the booby, 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 booby,
money, booby, 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 prizes, money, booby,
prize.
We're playing a game where you try and guess how much money is in Megan's boobies. Booby, 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 booby.
Booby, 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 booby.
Booby, 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 booby.
Booby, 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 booby.
Are we still going with this theme song? Because it's not working.
Shut up, Megan. It's trying our best.
It's going really well. We know it's between $25 and $28. We've had some good texts in. Someone says, I'm a girl and there isn't anything worse than working in retail and receiving sweaty boobs money.
I'm really sorry.
Someone has also said, we need to see to make an educated guess. Get away, you pervs. This is just about a practical way of holding some money. It's nothing sensual about it.
Elsie, what is your guess?
$27.50.
Oh my God, Elsie, you were so close. It's ridiculous.
So close, but no cigar for you, Elsie. We've already used that description, haven't we?
We'll use it again.
Helen, what's your guess?
$26.50.
No, Helen.
Oh, so close,
my God,
but
I'm
no
getting
cigar.
Anxious.
Higher or lower?
It's higher than that.
Okay, higher.
Just.
Oh, so close, but no
cigar.
Cigar.
Taryn, you get to have a wee guess of how much money is in Megan's boobies. What is your decision?
$27.20.
Yes, it is.
Woo!
Taryn, you've just won $27.20 of sweaty Megan's boob
you
money.
You so lucky. Oh, my God.
Taryn, how does it feel?
That's awesome. It's going to make my day.
Have you ever won anything before?
Yeah, I won a DVD player.
Well, this is better than that, mate. It's sweaty boob money. Thanks for playing. Win Megan's sweaty boob money. Booby, 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 booby.
Just out of interest, could you get a DVD player down there?
She probably could.
I would give it a go.
She'd give it a go.
If she can't get it in there, she'll get it in her other bag.
Guy, Sharyn, and Clint. Itch.
Edge.
I was just reading this article on BuzzFeed. It's like the 9 times it's really awkward to say you too. Like if you go to the movies and they give you the ticket and they're like, enjoy the show. And you're like, you too. And you walk off. And it made me think of all those other times in your life where you have these really awkward moments with people where they might ask how you are.
Yeah.
And you're just like, good, thanks, how are you? And you walk off. Or then after that, you realize they didn't actually ask how you were.
Yeah.
And
yeah.
then you have to pull it back and be like, oh, you didn't actually ask how I am, but I'm good in case you cared. And then you walk off, and it's so awkward.
If anytime anyone, doesn't happen a lot, but if anytime anyone compliments me on the street or something, they go, hey, man, really enjoy the show or something like that, I always go, thanks, man, I really appreciate it, and just keep on walking, right? The other day, someone goes, hey, mate, do you know the way to Surrey Cres? And I was just like, thanks, man, I really appreciate it, and just kept on walking like I was the most arrogant man in the world.
What a sad guy. Those people are probably still walking around wondering where Surrey Cres is.
They also thought I was mentally insane as well.
Well, that's a common assumption, let's be honest. Another one's when you, like, go to the restaurant, and they bring your food, and they're like, enjoy your meal. You too! And they look at you like, I'm not eating, you big bitch. I'm just serving you all night.
Sure, they don't say it quite that rude.
They do. They get,
understand
I,
what you're
I got, a waiter said I got to me, knifed once.
If a waiter said to me, I'm not eating you, big bitch.
That happened to me.
This place is unprofessional.
I probably wouldn't tip.
It happened to me and I got stabbed with a butter knife.
Really?
In the arm.
Did you die?
Yeah, but then I came back to life because I sucked the blood out.
This story got outrageous and very got, like, fast.
And then my pet phoenix flew from my house and knew it was in trouble and it cried its healing phoenix tears into my cat.
This does not sound
and
believable.
And I came back to life and I was like, where's Harry Potter? And it's how I'm here.
That does not sound believable at all.
That's what happened. J.K. Rowling wrote a book about it.
You too, bro.
I don't think anything of that story happened.
It did. Do you want to meet my pet
phoenix? Sharyn. I really appreciate it.
You too, you big bitch.
No!
Starting to doubt everything you've ever told me.
I am a pet phoenix with healing crying powers.
Thanks, Sharyn.
And I've got a friend with a lightning
bolt. You do not have a friend.
Guy, Sharyn and Clint on the Edge.
Okay, that's the end of the podcast.
We're actually doing it. We're in a pod. It's so exciting.
I can't believe we're not in a pod, but we are sitting on each other for some weird reason.
We are. If you don't believe us, go to our Facebook page and you'll see a picture of us. It's
Why are we
so
acting
good.
This out? We could just pretend we're in a pod because it's a radio show.
Chang's doing some footage.
Good work, Chang.
To paint a picture for you. Guy's at the back because Sharyn one of the tallest at the back. Then I'm sitting in his lap. And then Sharon's sitting in my lap.
Can I say that I'm not at the back because Sharyn wanted the tallest in the back. I'm at the back because Sharyn said, quote, she didn't want to touch my dick. Which is not the case at all. You wouldn't touch my dick. It would just go on, Sharyn. Oh, man. You make me seem so gross all the time. It makes me feel uncomfortable.
Where do we go from here, Sharyn?
I think we should just end with you farting on Guy and then we'll see you soon.
Thank you so much for listening to the podcast and welcome into Sharon's amazing mind. We'll be back with more of this madness tomorrow at the same time in the same place.
I'll try and get some sleep tonight.
Sharon's got a very warm bottom. Bye.
The Guy, Sharyn and Clint podcast.